Now, originally, I was gonna make a video solely on Disney and how they've become a train wreck. But, to be honest, the entirety of Hollywood has been a train wreck. Not just because most of the stuff they've been producing have been, well, not good, but also because they keep trying to shove down representation and, as the critical drinker says, the message down our throats. This can be seen with films like The Woman King, which can only be described as a woke wet dream for the activist who wrote it. Don't worry, we'll talk about that later, but before you move on, I just want to show you something. This is the tomato score for The Woman King, and this is the tomato score for the new Super Mario Bros. Movie. I feel like something is very wrong. Now, say what you will about this movie when it comes out, which I think is tomorrow, but if this movie, no matter how good or bad it is somehow worse than The Woman King, the Earth has reached rock bottom of the universe. Now, you think that these people just didn't enjoy the movie, and if you don't enjoy this movie, that's perfectly fine. However, this guy in particular thinks that these quote-unquote woke critics are review-bombing this movie because it isn't quote-unquote woke enough. And you know what's sad? That's entirely reasonable. The same guy also gives a pretty good point how Lightyear, one of Disney's biggest failures, which isn't really saying much, despite being bad and not getting a lot of money, it still was reviewed pretty well. Yet the Mario movie has it, and yes, I know it hasn't officially been released in theaters for everyone else to watch, but that really doesn't matter. But why did Lightyear, out of all movies, get reviewed so well? Well, it's because, unlike supposedly the Mario movie, it's not trying to be actually good entertainment, it's just trying to be a lecture that no one gives a crap about. I mean, just let me play the clip.
Talking about the same people that gave this pile of trash a 74%, Lightyear, one of the biggest flops of the year. But they loved it. Why'd they love this movie? Had a lot of progressive elements to it. Well, you know what movie doesn't have a lot of progressive elements to it? Super Mario Brothers, the movie. Off to a disappointing start on Rotten Tomatoes. That's right. How bad is it, you say? Well, let me show you. 46%.
Now, here's the thing. If your show or movie or whatever has a gay person or a black person or a whatever person, that doesn't mean anything. Most of the people don't care. It's just that this is used as a shield for any negative stuff. I mean, we saw this with The Woman King, with how if you didn't go and watch that movie, you were basically saying that black people couldn't lead the box office, or in other words, you were racist. This also happened with Wakanda Forever, which if you actually went to go see that movie, which you think would be a good thing, well no, you're also racist. They were basically using this as defense and saying that we were the bad people because we didn't like black, gay, or whatever people in our movies, when that isn't the case at all. Most of the time, the reason why we don't like these movies is because they're just bad movies. It has nothing to do with the actors. Most of the time. Now, these people, you should really act like they're your homework and just ignore them because at the end of the day, they're not gonna help you in the long run. At least for the most part. Anyway, that's gonna be the end of this video. If you liked it, like and subscribe. And I'll see you all the next one.